Question 11. What are the prerequisites to become a mobile tester? Answer. Mobile tester should know about the mobile technology development technology mobile platform OS knowledge on device supporting tool mobile protocols. Question 12. How to test protocols in mobile testing and how many protocols are used in mobile application? Answer. Actually the same TCP, IP concepts go in mobile apps also, but when it comes down to browsing apps, downloading apps, it is generally done via WAP gateway, not WAP server, which generally people confuse with. WAP is a standard defined to serve as a common platform, as we cannot directly hook on from normal TCP IP network to a mobile network, but it is definitely possible to call, SMS, sending mail from any browser to a mobile device, and vice versa. Question 13. Explain difference between 2 grams and 3 grams in mobile phone testing. Answer. 2G and 3G is a family of standards for mobile telecommunications defined by the International Telecommunication Union, which includes GSM Edge, UMTS, and CDMA 2000 as well as DECTN WiMAX. Services include wide area wireless voice telephone, video calls, and wireless data, all in a mobile environment. 2G stands for second generation mobile telephony standards, where 3G defined the third generation mobile telephony standards to facilitate growth, increase bandwidth, and support more diverse applications. For example, GSM, the current most popular cellular phone standard, could deliver not only voice, but also circuit switch data at download rates up to 14.4 kilobits per second. But to support mobile multimedia applications, 3G had to deliver packet switch data with better spectral efficiency, at far greater bandwidths. Question 14. What areas of applications can be covered under wireless testing? Answer. Basically, call module should be covered for wireless testing. After that, all the applications should be tested, how those applications behave when a call is received being in that application. Question 15. How to get voice over wireless testing? Answer. There are test labs to test the voice over wireless testing. Otherwise, you can use 2 of our test mobiles and can put any operator's SIM card just like our own mobile and can test it. Most of the companies provide some operator's SIM cards to test. Question 16. How we test battery backup time using load testing, specially for mobile testing? Answer. Procedure of battery testing. Battery backup test for idle mode. Fully charge the battery. Make sure no calls should be made on boot start timer. When fully charge it, wait until the battery drain out. Fully battery backup test for dedicated mode. Again, fully charge the battery. Make a call to a test phone from boot start timer. When call is connected, wait until the battery is fully drained out. Match all the readings from user manual and check the battery leakage. Question 17. How is wireless network adapters tested? Answer. Check that the wireless network adapter is on and verified by LED glow. Check that the wireless network adapter is suited for the different OS. Check the wireless network adapter is able to pass installation testing. Check that the wireless network adapter is able to configure. Check the data flows in out functions for the wireless network adapter. Check the flow rate of data and should not break up. Check the time delay taken for every process. Data transmission should not be freeze at any situation. Question 18. How to do tracing in wireless testing? Answer. Wired side AP fingerprinting, wired side MAC prefix analysis, wireless side wallwalking, wireless side client monitoring, wireless side WLAN IDs. Question 19. What should the testers know to able to perform wireless testing effectively? Answer. Testers must be able to think lot of scenarios relating to calls. For example, when a call comes and at the same time alarm rings, how the system behaves, or say when the mobile is busy with a call at the time one more call comes, how the system behaves, etc. There can be a lot of scenarios like this. Question 20. How should the analysis be performed by a tester before carrying out wireless testing? Answer. White box testing provides the testers with complete knowledge of the infrastructure to be tested, often including network diagrams, source code, and IP addressing information. It can be performed to validate whether code implementation follows intended design, to validate implemented security functionality, and to uncover exploitable vulnerabilities.